Sergeant Preston of the Northwest Mounted Police with Yukon King, swiftest and strongest lead dog breaking the trail in the relentless pursuit of lawbreakers in the wild days of the Yukon. Back to the days of the gold rush as Sergeant Preston with his wonder dog Yukon King meets the challenge of the Yukon. This is the Yukon in Arctic winter, the territory patrolled by Sergeant Preston, where men like the land itself sometimes conceal unexpected qualities beneath a forbidding exterior. On the other side of treacherous Carlson Pass, which was frequently blocked by storms, Porcupine Flat was the most civilized village of its size in the Yukon. Sergeant Preston always looked forward to the patrols that brought him to this well-ordered, law-abiding community. As a result of its good reputation and beautiful natural setting, Porcupine Flat attracted the more stable element among those who came to the far north in the quest for gold. But all around was still the untouched wilderness, and to an adventurous boy like young Danny Lawson, it seemed a paradise.
Come on, Pootsie. Oh, come on. Worms to the creek. Here, do you want a pretzel? All right, you go get it. What's the matter, Pootsie? Oh, golly, a trap. Wait, Pootsie, I'll get you out of there. Please, Pootsie, don't cry. My dog, he's caught in a trap. I can't pry him loose. Help me, mister.
Traps. Ought to be a law against them. Yeah, let's take a look at that leg, doggy. Well, no bones broken, thank goodness. Now, you come along with me, sonny. We'll fix him up as good as new.
What's yours? My mama runs a restaurant. You gonna stay here long?
Oh, there, sonny. One question at a time, huh? No, I don't live here. Just passing through. And I've got a boy at home just your age.
What's his name?
Bobby. Bobby Smith.
Gee, Pootsie sure likes you. That's the way he licked Sergeant Preston's hand, too.
Sergeant Preston? A mommy?
Yes, he just came in from Dawson. I'm gonna be a Mountie when I grow up. Sergeant Preston says that...
Here's your dog, Danny. It's all fixed up. You better run along now.
You in a hurry, Mr. Smith?
Yes, I've got to go up to Carlson Pass. Business.
You'll come back, though.
Oh, sure. So long now.
So long, and thanks.
Here you are, Sergeant.
Oh, that's wonderful, Mrs. Lawson. Be a big bone for you, too, King.
Here's Danny now, Sergeant.
Well, hello, Danny. How's my littlest recruit?
Fine, thanks, Sergeant. Hello, King.
How about a kiss for Mother?
Oh, sure, Mom.
Now, wait a minute. You can't kiss your mother the right way with that dog in your arms.
May I have some pretzels?
I knew I didn't get that kiss for nothing. Help yourself.
Hey, what happened to Pootsie, Danny?
Well, I got caught in a trap.
Well, whoever bandaged it did a good job.
Mr. Smith got him out and bandaged him and everything.
Mr. Smith, the lawyer?
No, this was another Mr. Smith. Never saw him before.
Well, we'll have to thank him.
I did, but he was in a big hurry to go over Carlson Pass.
Carlson Pass?
Yeah, he has a boy just my age, named Bobby.
Well, I just came from there and it snowed in. Very treacherous. We'd better warn you, Mr. Smith.
But your steak, Sergeant.
Here, save it for me, will you, Mrs. Lawson?
Will you take Pootsie and me?
Well, it's all right with your mother.
May I, Mom?
All right.
Okay, here, you take Pootsie and jump on the sled. Go ahead.
Oh, Hit the boy.
Ho, King, ho! You can jump out, Danny.
Hello, Mr. Smith.
Hello, Danny.
This is Sergeant Preston. I told you about him.
That's right, you did. How are you? Hello, Sergeant.
Danny tells me you plan to go over Carlson Pass, Mr. Smith.
Is there any law against it?
No. No, of course not. I wanted to warn you. I just came back from there. The pass is snowed in.
Thanks, but I can take care of myself.
You live here?
No, I'm just passing through.
Where are you from, Mr. Smith?
Oregon, why?
Have you ever been in the Paiute gold fields?
No. No, I haven't.
Do you have any identification with you?
Say, what is this?
I'm looking for a man by the name of McQuaid. He's wanted in a shooting scrape down in Paiute. You answer the description.
Maybe a lot of other people do, too.
Maybe. So if you can prove your identity, I'd appreciate it.
I can.
Should be simple. Letter, card, or piece of paper with your name on it?
I haven't got any. My sled took a spill on Devil's Ravine on the way over here. I lost all that stuff.
Well, in that case, I'd better search the cabin.
I guess there's no way I can stop you. Only I just finished loading all my gear in my sled.
Well, there's nothing in here to identify you. What about your pockets?
Now, look here, Sergeant. You're going too far, don't you think?
Well, I'm only doing my job, Mr. Smith. I must insist that... All right, come on, get up, Smith. Now, let me see what's in your pocket. Is this your wife and son? Sorry, Smith. Why did you object to showing me this?
I think some things are private. Even from the police. It's been a long time since I've seen these two. Looks like it's going to be even longer. I'm sorry I lost my head and took a poke at you.
It's all right. I'll forget about it. I still think I'll have a look at the cabin. Wait here, please. Guard him, King. He won't bother you unless you try to leave.
You know, Mr. Smith is not a bad man.
Well, sometimes it's hard to tell, Danny. Now, that photograph was wet and crumpled like it had been damaged in a sled overturn. That's evidence to bear out his story.
What do you think you'll find, Sergeant?
Well, I don't know, Danny. Policeman has to keep an open mind. See, it's just possible that Mr. Smith left something behind that could identify him. That'd be to his advantage. We'll go back to the constable's office and send a telegram to Paiute Lake requesting information about the man we're looking for. Let's go.
Well, Sergeant, you satisfied? Gonna take me to jail?
No, I have no evidence to hold you. But we're returning to the constable's office to wire Paiute for more information, so don't leave town.
Now look here, Mountie.
I'll make it as fast as I can, Mr. Smith. Come on, King. Let's go, Danny.
He's lying.
A few minutes, we'll be getting out of here.
Oh! End of the line, Danny. Tell your mother I'll be ready for that steak in a few minutes.
Sure thing, Sergeant. And thanks for the ride.
Thanks for the company.
Where'd you get this? Tobacco. Mr. Smith is smoking a pipe. I bet it's his. MCQ. McQuaid. And Mr. Smith is the man Sergeant Preston is looking for. We better tell him. Wait. We know Mr. Smith is not a bad man. He saved your life. Mr. Smith must have a good explanation for this. We'll question him just like Sergeant Preston would. Come on, boy.
Well, Mrs. Lawson, I'm ready for that steak if it's ready for me.
It'll take a few minutes, Sergeant. I didn't know you were coming.
Didn't Danny tell you?
Why, no. He didn't come in. I saw him running down the street.
Well, that's odd. I asked him to let you know.
Yes, it is strange. Danny is usually very reliable. I wondered about the direction he took.
What do you mean?
The trail to Carlson Pass.
Carlson Pass?
Well, where are you going, Sergeant?
Get Danny.
Oh, he'll only go as far as the bend. That's all he's permitted.
Well, I'll just check anyway.
He's not in any danger, is he?
Of course not, Mrs. Lawson. I'll be back just as soon as possible.
It was not as unlikely as it might seem that a boy on foot could for a while evade a mounted policeman with a sled and team, or overtake a fugitive similarly equipped. Danny knew every ridge, gully, and tree for miles around. He took shortcuts known only to himself. Even so, Danny might have been outdistanced had not McQuaid run into trouble.
Mr. Smith!
Mr. Smith! Must be hearing things.
Mr. Smith!
Quiet, you huskies. Line up. Ha!
It's getting cold. Go get Mr. Smith, boy. Get him, boy.
Oh! Oh, boy. Yeah. Get this. Where's Danny? Over there? Okay, Foxy, let's go.
Great Scott. How to take him back to town, but...
Not daring to go back to Porcupine Flat and risk meeting Preston, McQuaid continued along the trail to a way station, one of many cabins in the Yukon maintained and equipped by the Northwest Mounted Police for the use of weary travelers.
Mr. Smith.
Take it easy, Danny.
Sergeant Preston.
Preston? What about him?
Preston drove his team hard behind the great lead dog, Yukon King, toward Carlson Pass.
Just as I thought. And he's taking a shortcut trying to catch up with Smith. If that's his name. Now, this is going to be tough. We can do it. Sure we can. All right, give me a Hawking. Ha!
He was greatly concerned over what might have happened when the boy met the man Preston suspected might be an outlaw.
Thank you.
Okay, ho!
This boy weren't in the line of fire.
You're being smart, Monty. All right. Unfasten the gun from your lanyard and toss it on the bed. That's better. Now you're going outside and turn your sled over. That'll anchor your team.
Don't touch that rifle. That's good, Monty. Now come back inside.
Takes care of your dogs. All right, get your handcuffs out. Toss them to me. Now put your hands behind you. Any tricks and the boy's liable to suffer. He's in pretty bad shape.
You've done anything to Danny?
Sit down.
What have you done to this boy?
When it came to warn me, you were after me. Before he could find me, the cold got him.
How bad is he?
Caught him in time, I hope. And after I see he's out of danger, I'm shoving off. You know, he risked his life to warn me you were after me. And I aim to see he didn't take that chance for nothing.
I wasn't after you, McQuaid. At least not until I knew Danny was missing. As a matter of fact, I was wiring Paiute Lake for more information. Then I was prepared to give you the benefit of the doubt until then.
What Danny said?
Danny must have known something he didn't tell me. Isn't that right, Mr. McQuaid?
Forget it. I've got to build a fire for Danny.
No wood.
Sorry I had to use all the wood. We'll replace it on my return trip. Klondike Shorty. Those little blasted sardos.
Mounted police maintain these way stations for the use of travelers, McQuaid.
It's gotta have a fire.
You can't come here while you cut wood. This boy needs immediate attention.
Don't you think I know that, you...
This is a two-man job, McQuaid. Unlock these handcuffs.
Oh, no, you don't, Monty. What kind of a fool do you take me for?
You know, McQuaid, you don't look like the kind of a man that would like to see a boy die. The boy the same age as your own son.
All right. I'll make a deal with you.
The Northwest Mounted Police don't make deals, McQuaid.
I could kill you.
Yes, you could. And that would end Danny's chances.
All right. Have it your own way. But I'm not going to jail, see? I'm getting out of here. And now!
Suppose this were your own son, McQuaid, the young fellow in your picture. As I said before, we don't make deals. But I'll tell you this much. My primary duty is to save life.
What do you mean by that?
I mean that until Danny is out of danger, I'll perform no other duty.
And after he's out of danger?
Then I'll arrest you.
If you can.
If I can.
All right. That's good enough for me. Where are the keys?
In my side pocket. I'll cut some wood.
Free that dog.
Knowing that something was wrong inside the cabin, King was growing increasingly restless. But Preston calmed his great dog and told him the moment for action had not yet come. And so began perhaps the strangest truce ever made between two men of the far north. One an outlaw facing arrest and prison. The other the lawman dedicated to capturing him. Both united to save the life of a small boy. Knowing that the instant their goal was achieved, they would once more become deadly enemies. That possibly only one of them would leave this room alive. After 2 hours, Danny began to show signs of improvement.
Baby's gonna be all right, McQuaid.
All right, Nonny. The kid's come out of it and the truce is over. I'm leaving.
No, you're not. You're coming with me.
Don't be a fool, Preston. I'm arresting you in the name of the Crown. You take one more step and I'll fire.
I don't think you will, McQuaid. Give me the gun.
Taking you in, McQuaid. You drive your own dog team, and I'll follow you right behind you. Spring right in here.
Daddy, are you all right?
Sure, Mom. Can I have a pretzel?
Well, that should prove that he's all right. Danny turned his ankle on the trail and nearly froze.
Nearly froze.
But he's all right now, Mrs. Lawson. Don't worry.
I don't know how to thank you, Sergeant.
Well, don't thank me. You have Mr. McQuaid here to thank. Not to mention,
Good old Pussy. Get a pretzel, boy. Go on.
Well, come on, McQuaid. Attend to our business over at the constable's office.
Hello, Sergeant. I saw your team outside, so I thought I'd better bring this over. It's the information on the McQuaid man you wired for.
Thanks, Constable. Why didn't you tell me about this, McQuaid?
Tell you what? That a shot a man, maybe killed him?
Partner isn't dead. He's recovering.
What difference does it make? It'll be great news for my wife and child to learn I can't come home because I'm in prison, won't it?
Mm-hmm. Says here, the argument started over the abuse of a sled dog.
That's right. Makes my blood boil to see anybody abuse an animal.
Witnesses further testify that your partner pulled his gun first. That makes it self-defense. I think after a few technicalities are worked out, your wife and son will be seeing a free man. And soon.
Thank you, Sergeant. One more thing. What made you so sure I wouldn't shoot you?
And I wasn't. But a policeman has to take chances. As well as being a good judge of character. Then I had the word of a future recruit here that says that you couldn't possibly be a bad man.
That's all right, Putsy. You and King deserve a reward. Meet Hardy, boys. This case is closed.